If you've ever placed hydrogen peroxide on a cut, you will notice that bubbles form. These bubbles are oxygen molecules which are formed from the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide, which is catalyzed by the enzyme catalase, which is found in the blood. When we write a chemical reaction that has a catalyst, we write the name of the catalyst above or below the arrow because it is neither a reactant or a product. In the absence of a catalyst, hydrogen peroxide decomposes very, very slowly. So catalase is an example of an enzyme, and enzymes are biological catalysts. So we know that temperature increases reaction rate, and unless we have a fever, our body temperature is going to remain constant. So we need enzymes to allow reactions to occur quickly. Most biochemical reactions require enzymes to occur. Most enzymes are proteins, and they can make a reaction occur up to 10 million times faster. Enzymes speed up reactions by keeping reactants in a particular orientation or immobilizing them so they will react readily. This occurs at what's known as an active site, where the orientation for reaction occurs. And enzymes are highly specific. When they are defective, the result is often a diseased state in an organism. And Table 5.3 lists several enzyme-based diseases, and the enzyme that is sort of the culprit for these diseases. For example, Tay-Sachs disease is caused by a defect in the hexaminidase A enzyme, and that can result in mental retardation, blindness, muscular weakness, and eventually death.